Hi, I'm Daphne Richards. Our question this week comes from viewer James Grammer, who recently noticed a powdery white substance on the leaves of his oak tree. Well, James, from your photo, it appears to be a bit of a powdery mildew infestation. Although it's unsightly, powdery mildew isn't usually too much to worry about, at least not on a deciduous or semi-evergreen species such as oak, which will drop these leaves and make new ones at some point anyway. With our relative mild winter, coupled with warm spring days and cooler, wetter than normal spring nights, I've seen lots of odd fungal infections this year that wouldn't normally be a problem. If your tree is otherwise healthy, it will outgrow this issue without any intervention from you. It may drop these leaves fairly quickly on its own, or it may not. With the temperatures warming up now for summer and the days being much sunnier, these fungal spores aren't going to be hopping around infesting anything else. So just keep an eye on the situation and water the tree as normal this summer. Our plant this week is prickly pear, genus Opuntia, of which there are many lovely species, cultivars, and varieties to choose from. Common prickly pear may be seen all over South and West Texas, growing along roadsides and in rocky hill country areas. They really aren't even noticeable until springtime each year when they start to put on their stunning blooms. Common prickly pear most often has bright yellow blooms, but occasionally a yellowish pink may be seen. Cultivated choices include bunny ears with smaller, rounder pads and shorter golden yellow spines, and Santa Rita, which is a real showstopper in the landscape with its vibrant purple pads. The tunas, or fruit, produced by prickly pears are edible, as are the pads, known as nopalitos, once the spines are removed, of course. Depending on species, prickly pears can get pretty tall and wide, but most start to lay on the ground once they get taller than they can support. Plant in full sun, in rocky, very well-drained soil, and water sparingly. Although a few are thornless, most are not, so plant away from sidewalks and entryways. If you have any clay in your soil at all, consider planting prickly pear on elevated berms with added decomposed granite to keep them from rotting in our cool, wet winters. Recently, we featured James Borella's photo of a mantis oatheca, and James followed up with video of the baby mantids once they hatched. This is so cool. Lisa Bowman, who blogs at Greenbow, is working on her first bonsai, a Japanese maple that she's wiring into a cascade. Lisa said she's always admired the small trees, plants, moss, and rocks that are all part of the whole scene. And in Hutto, Jessica and Lance Romy got a great shot of three bees feasting on a zucchini blossom in their vegetable garden. We'd love to hear from you, so please send us your great shots, videos, and questions to klru.org/ctg.